In this video, we'll be learning about two independent samples tests, tests for variance and tests for mean. So, consider over here one scenario of two populations, population 1, population 2. We are considering normal distribution of both the populations. Well, if both the population values follow normal distribution, then the characteristics of both the populations will be arithmetic mean mu and variance sigma square. Let us consider that mu 1 is arithmetic mean for population 1 and sigma 1 square variance for population 1. Similarly, mu 2 and sigma 2 square as mean and variances for population 2. Now, if we want to say that two populations are same or the characteristics of two populations are same, then we mean to say that, basically we mean to prove that sigma 1 square is equal to sigma 2 square and mu 1 is equal to mu 2. So we'll be having two hypothesis tests in this case. One is proving whether sigma 1 square is equal to sigma 2 square, and another one is proving whether mu 1 is equal to mu 2. Hence, we mean to say that we have two hypothesis tests to learn in this video, one for comparing variances and another one for comparing arithmetic means. For comparing variances, there are various options. One of them is F-test, Levenis test, Bartlett's test. Now, over here, I am presenting the formula of Bartlett's test, and we will also see Python options related to Bartlett's test. You will find one thing, that the null hypothesis is basically not for just two variances. This test is meant for testing for multiple populations. Well, we are going to see here one example related to CO2 uptake of 6 plants with different blocks and two treatments. Well, one treatment is chilled, so there are some chilled plants and non-chilled plants, and we are going to see the uptake of chilled plants and non-chilled plants. We are going to compare the uptake values for chilled and non-chilled in this problem. Well, this is the meta data of the data set, in which we have plant, well, we have type of the plant, treatment of the plant, there are other values also. For us, what is important for this problem is this particular column and this column. Hence, we consider firstly the variances. Well, why are we considering the variances? You will come to know within few minutes. So first of all, what I am going to do is I am going to perform the test for equality of variances. There is a Python function over here called stats.bartlett. You will see that the two columns have been extracted for for the chilled, one is for the chilled and another is for non-chilled. In our this data set, you will find that there are values non-chilled and chilled for the column treatment. This is the uptake column. So now what has been done over here is that we have extracted separately the non-chilled uptake column into one object and chilled uptake column in another object accordingly, and then we have performed the Bartlett's test. We see with the result of this Bartlett's test that we have p value which is less than 0.05, which indicates that we are inclined towards null hypothesis or not rejecting null hypothesis. So it may happen that variances may be equal. Well, let me tell you now, before I carried out test for means, why did I test for variances? Because t-test for means is having two types. One is t-test assuming equality of variances, and another is independent samples t-test assuming inequality of the variances. So firstly, we require to test the variance, whether the variances are equal in both the samples, and once we are convinced that they are equal or unequal, accordingly we are going to use one of these tests which are applicable. Following are the details of these tests. So one is, you see, two samples test with equal variances, you will find that with this we have pooled the variance. So considering both the variances are equal in two samples, what we have done is we have combined the variance in the formula and use that variance in the test statistic. That is one way of doing it. With the, it has a degrees of freedom in this way. And another is assuming unequal variances, where we have treated two variances separately with a specific degrees of freedom calculated. Now in our problem, we already have seen that variances are equal. As you saw in this test of Bartlett's, that variances are equal. So if for this problem variances are seen to be equal, then the formula of independent samples t-test with equality of variances needs to be used. So considering this, we have the null and alternative hypothesis. Firstly, we will test it for two-tailed test. And following is the function related to t-test. It is stats.t_test_ind. Okay. Now over here in this function, you will find that the two columns have been passed. At the same time, the third option which you see, which has been specified here, is important. =var is equal to true. If our earlier hypothesis could have been rejecting of H0 for sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square, that is, if our earlier test could have resulted in unequal variances, then we could have written over here equal variance is equal to false. But we are writing over here true because it is applicable. Hence we have over here, you see, the p p-value of it. Now the p-value, you see it is less than 0.05. Also we see it is less than 0.01. So we can conclude that the mean uptake of plants for two different treatments may be unequal at 5% level of significance, also at 1% level of significance. If we see through the data set, the mean of uptake for chilled and non-chilled, we see mean uptake for chilled to be less than non-chilled. Obviously, this is basically sample finding. We are yet to conclude on population. Well, on the population, you see that if we really require to prove that mu for chilled is less than mu for non-chilled, well, if this is our hypothesis, then this hypothesis obviously should be in H1 because this contains inequality. So corresponding hypothesis in H0 will be mu for chilled, well, less than or equal to mu for non-chilled. Hence you find that this test is a lower tail test. Hence our hypothesis will be mu1 or mu chilled greater than or equal to mu non-chilled versus mu chilled less than non-chilled. But our Python function gets us two-tailed p-value. Okay. So by default you will find that our t-test underscore ind will be giving us this type of p-value. But for our test of lower tail, that is one-tailed, it is, we require the p-value which will be at the left. Considering the shape of the graph, we see that this p-value is equally distributed. So even if we take the half of it, then that will be one-tailed value. So let us calculate that. Hence we have the one-tailed p-value calculated, and one-tailed p-value reveals as 0.0015, which is again less than 0.05. Hence we reject H0, and hence we have proved over here that mean uptake values of chilled plants may be less than that of non-chilled plants. So before I conclude this video, let me first of all tell you the roadmap of how the two independent samples test should be done. So you see, to start with, test for sigma 1 square is equal to sigma 2 square. So first of all, see whether is sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square. Is it? If it is, if yes, then assume the test for equality of test with equality of variances. So in the function of our t-test, you will be providing equal var is equal to true if this sigma 1 square is equal to sigma 2 square is there. If it is not there, then in that case equal var is equal to false should be given in that function. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to press the like button, and for latest updates from me, please subscribe my channel and also press bell icon for latest notifications for you. Thank you.